Hi guys, I got a new and exciting kit that we've just released. Well, an add-on actually. Due to popular demand, we realized that we really needed something like this. What it is we call it the Auxilary Heated Plating Beaker Station. And it has a built-in heater on it, and it holds your beaker, because there are a lot of people who have the Jewel Master or Universal Plater and want to have the ability to have a bath set up with either nickel, rose, gold, rhodium, something like that. So we've created this little setup that has plugs in the back that you can plug into your rectifier, or in this case it runs to the Jewel Master. The example I want to use for this situation is, let's say you're a jeweler and you had earrings that you wanted to rose gold plate. If you just have the Jewel Master as it comes, you have to swap out this beaker with the rose gold, because rose gold plated stuff needs to be yellow gold plated first. So I'm going to show you how we do it with this new setup that we've made. Here we've got our earrings, and just imagine these are earrings. They're actually fishing lures, but it doesn't make a difference. So we go ahead and put them in the ElectroClean first. Now, ElectroClean just removes any sort of grease or fingerprints and stuff like that off the surface, and really gets it hydrophilic, meaning that the solution can easily access it. If you have stainless steel or even nickel like these, if you do not ElectroClean them well, you can get spots and marks if you just go straight to the gold. So ElectroCleaner is a really handy solution, and it's really critical as a first step for really almost any plating process. We come to the rinse, just kind of get all that excess off of there. Now this next solution is called Surface Activator. Surface Activator is an acetic solution that activates the surface, as simple as that is. And it's really only about 10-15 seconds for most metals. And Surface Activator works for almost every metal except stainless steel. With stainless steel, you have to use Wood's Nickel Strike. So Surface Activator is a really great addition to any plating setup. And it comes stock with the Jewel Master option 2. All right, now we're gonna yellow gold plate. Before we do that, we're gonna turn the voltage down, because gold works at a lot lower voltage than those previous two. So I put it in and adjust the voltage up to 2.8. That's the sweet spot. Now this is a hardened 24 karat gold. It's 99.7% plus purity, but it does have hardeners and brighteners in it that make it significantly harder than if it were just a pure gold solution. The purple stuff in it is the hardeners and brighteners. And we've formulated this solution to where it's just one of the best gold solutions on the market. In only, 20 seconds, it's already turned a nice gold color. And since we're going to be rose gold plating them, we'll just move right ahead, because yellow gold wasn't the final. It was just kind of an underplate for the rose gold. Okay, so now we're going to come into the rose gold over here in the auxiliary station. And we're going to stick it in and turn the voltage up. Rose gold works at a little bit higher voltage. And it also requires heating. And so this little station is critical if you're going to be doing rose gold, this type of setup where you want to yellow gold and then rose gold plate. This heater will get it up to about 150, which is something important, because nickel requires higher temperatures as well in order to work well. But after about 30 seconds, these will be a nice rose gold color. You can plate them up to about 2 minutes before you'll start to get a little bit of haziness. But yeah, 30 seconds to a minute gets a nice rose color. So let's check them out and see how they're coming. They're looking great. We'll just, for the purpose of keeping this video short, we'll just stop there. So yeah, it's as easy as that. I mean, you could imagine this whole rack being full of four different sets of earrings. And there, in just the couple minutes that we made this, you'd have some rose gold plated earrings done. You could, again, you could put rhodium in that third or fourth beaker cell there, or nickel. Here's some that we did before, just to kind of show some contrast of difference. This is the 24K yellow, and this is the rose gold. And here's the earrings, and they're quite shiny, so it's hard to see the color much, but they turned out great. So yeah, that's the auxiliary beaker station. We have a heated and a unheated one because there are certain solutions that don't require heating, such as copper and some others that maybe people want to just put Wood's nickel strike there because they do stainless steel sometimes and nickel other times. So yeah, keep an eye out for this. It's going to be getting on our website here really soon, and hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you.